What's up guys, in this video we're going to talk in depth about a theory that is super likely to happen, and that's about the Norse Sisters of Fate called the Norns. But before we get into it, consider joining the Spartan Army. We are over 14,000 members strong, with community videos that happen once a week, hilarious streams where we play God of War games every night, and videos uploaded every day, and much more. If you want people who got your back in battle, then hit that subscribe button. Make friends in the comment section down below, and let's get right into the video. The World Tree Yggdrasil connects the nine realms together, the spine of life. Many live in the nine realms, from the Fire of Muspelheim, housing the fire giants, to Vanaheim, sheltering the veneer gods, to Midgard, home to the thriving mortals, or to Jotunheim, where the giants gather and create. On the foot of the world tree lies three beings who sit at the foot of this sacred tree. Together, these three beings are called Norns. These three sisters, I feel, will be coming after our heroes, Kratos and Atreus, for they have changed the fates of everyone in Norse. But first, who are the Norns? The Norns are made up of three sisters. The first one is Urd, which means what once was, Verdandi, which means what is coming into being, and Skuld, meaning what shall be. The three Norns are the goddesses of fate. They spend most of their time spinning the threads to life, to decide the fate of all living beings. The three Norns do this by sitting at the foot of the world tree, and weave the fate of every living being into a web or thread. The three Norns start every morning by placing a rooster at the top of the world tree. The sound of the rooster is a wake-up call for all the gods and goddesses in Asgard. Every morning, the Norns also carry water from Urd's well and pour it over Yggdrasil, which is the tree of life. The water from this well is very important because it keeps the world tree green and healthy. In Norse myth, as we've seen in God of War, the future is very set in stone. Eventually, at some point, Ragnarok was supposed to happen. It seems everyone knows about it. All over the game, you could find murals depicting the past, present, and future. The flow of time seems to be set in the realms. The Norns themselves seem to be accepting of this, since they are the ones that weave the flow of time. Similar to God of War 2, as we saw Kratos weaving a web that was about him, we saw the events from his past. But it seems the Norns didn't count on Kratos entering Norse mythology. Kratos and Atreus, for some reason, is an unknown factor. Maybe just Kratos alone. Kratos doesn't really care much for fate. Out of all the many murals and depictions of the future in God of War, Atreus and Kratos aren't on any of them but the one that is hidden in Jotunheim. Have you, watching this video, ever really thought about why? Kratos and Atreus have more impact on the Norse world already more than pretty much anybody. They've bested both Baldur, Modi, and Magni. They've confronted and assisted by Mimir and the World Serpent, even Odin's ex-wife Freya. Kratos set Ragnarok in motion with Baldur's death, and you're telling me not one mural was dedicated to Kratos and Atreus besides the one at the end? The only explanation I can think about is that Kratos and Atreus exist outside the flow of time to the Norns, not in the plans of the Norns. More evidence of this lies with the ending, when Mimir and Kratos have a short conversation about how Kratos changed something. Also, when the World Serpent, who is from the future, sees Atreus, he can't remember how he knows Atreus, just remarking he looks familiar. You're telling me that the World Serpent remembers Thor, Ragnarok, and things about the future, but can't remember how he knows Atreus? That's just more evidence both father and son, for some reason, are lost to time when it comes to the Norns. Kratos and Atreus have changed the course of time. Ragnarok is starting hundreds of winters earlier than expected. Everyone's fate has moved up a couple of years, including the keepers of time, the Norns. There is no doubt in my mind they are angry with the flow of time being disrupted. Only they should have the power to change. Not even Odin could control them. I believe Odin used Kratos and Atreus to change the fate of Ragnarok. That's a theory for another day. But if all this is true, that means Fae was so powerful to see the future that only she saw a future with Kratos and Atreus in it. Not even the Norns saw a future where Kratos and Atreus both changed so much. I think if they knew what Kratos and Atreus would do, she would try to stop it. But that's it for this video. What do you guys think about the Norns? Are they gonna go after Kratos and Atreus for changing the flow of time and coming down upon them? Do you think that the Norns would win or would they lose? Check out the videos on your screen. The one on the right talks about some news, everything we know about God of War 5. Also, check out the two playlists that are on your screen, which is God of War 5 Theories, as well as the God of War streams that we've been doing constantly. I'm gonna be out of here. Thank you guys for listening. Deuces.